I'm already video. I'm video recording. Go away.
Do you want to introduce your special friend over here?
Yeah, this is Tori, my girlfriend. She is a fan of all vintage sci-fi. So she got a DVD, and actually Chris gave her a free vintage DVD.
Look at that!
What?
That is so awesome. I'm sure it'll be framed up on the wall.
No. Way, dude.
Yourself?
I did.
You got sand in there. You got a beautiful diorama work. Oh, come on, Geonosis. All right. Oh, my.
Hey guys, we are in Indianapolis at the Toy Drop. My buddy Clint Hot Dogs told me about this wonderful toy store, and I went in, met the owner just a moment ago, and I coincidentally met the owner a while back at the Kane County Toy Show in Chicago, but he has an awesome place. I wanted to show you around. Clint and I will introduce you to him and kind of just do a walkthrough. You ready?
Yeah, ready.
Who's this?
This is Diaz, my dog. He kind of goes everywhere with us.
I thought this was a toy.
Yeah, he's a toy.
He's a toy dog.
He's a toy Yorkie. He's not worth as much.
And I love the patch. Is that your favorite Mad Ball?
Favorite Mad Ball, yeah.
Awesome. Well, let's go on in and have some fun. Feast your eyes, not on us, but on the wonderfulness. Come on.
Nice to meet you.
You have a wonderful store.
How
long have you been in operation?
We have been in operation under this name for 3 years, but a total of about 6.5 years, almost going on 7.
Wow. And your specialty, I mean, I saw pretty much a whole, every toy line from most eras, but what are you truly passionate about yourself?
I am an 80s kid, so anything Star Wars, He-Man, all the 80s is still the sweet spot. It's still my favorite and still learning about it.
Yes.
The 80s was a great time, Cartoon Saturday, and just the pop culture and the amazing. So the 80s, the vintage, I guess they call it vintage, but 80s, 70s and 80s is the sweet spot for me.
Awesome. Well, can we walk around
and
just
kind of
look at some things? And camera woman, if you want to just kind of pan around. So we start off, we got some Mint on Card, Ninja Turtles over here, Dune, which they're remaking.
Yeah.
Yes, check this out.
One of my favorite movies, actually.
Yes,
I love Dune.
Hit
they're
that
remaking
subscribe
it.
Button.
Super excited. But a lot of unique toy lines, like the Eagle Force, and down here, Biker Mice from Mars.
You know what I mean? And it's stuff that you don't see, like Pee-wee's Playhouse. You never see a Mint on Box Pee-wee's Playhouse anymore.
Yeah, right up here.
And you know, a lot of people don't carry this line. These are some of my favorites, like the Masters KOs.
Yes.
They did that DC mashup, too, that I remember.
They did Savage World.
Yeah.
Wrestling is huge. I bought massive wrestling lots, and they just go quickly. I am surprised. Because wrestling's not a huge passion of mine. Typically, it's the He-Man, which he's got a nice selection of them. You got Squeeze.
He's great.
The Catra from Princess of Power. Some of the modern 2000Xs. The knockoffs I kind of enjoy. And then the Imperial Toys, which is like the hard rubber. These ones I really like.
Oh yeah,
I love because they match perfectly. This is what did they call him?
That was Thorn. It was
a failed cartoon series.
But it was actually really funny.
Was it? I never watched
it. He's got some rare stuff too. He's got a Scareglow over here, and his prices are great.
Oh, check out Scareglow.
What's Scareglow?
Right there. Box. I mean, the artwork on the boxes, I love. And you got unused contents, complete.
I haven't really come across this many times.
I don't even know what that is. And you know,
well, the Talon Fighter.
I know what the Talon Fighter is.
Right, but this is the model kit, which looks pretty much the same, but different color schemes, and you had to obviously put it together. But yeah, like you said, the Scare Glow. You get into the modern Marvel Legends. Just a nice assortment of figures. And then the higher end stuff. I don't see this too often. The Hot Toys and Sideshows that are the super detailed figures. And you can see the price tag. That's what they retail. It's not like they've gone up in value. They might have a little bit once they become unavailable. But they're several hundred dollars just to begin with.
Oh, and you really enjoy clowns.
Get that out of the shot. I hate clowns.
There you go,
MC. I hate them. Further continuing, my jam, G.I. Joe.
That's the thing, you know. One, I mean, G.I. Joes are not affordable anymore, but like a Zartania for $18 is well under retail. I mean, eBay, I think I just sold it for like 26.
Yeah, I believe it. And she had two different head sculpts.
Earrings. And
the earring and non-earring. In the case, some of the 90s G.I. Joes, like the Battle Corps. I used to buy these suckers for like $5 a piece all the time. But now the 90s kids are having disposable income, and like anything, they increase in value. Really nice collection of various things. Let me throw in, you know, Disney memorabilia.
Any more clowns in here?
So what he's talking about is Beast Wars up on this cabinet. Beast Wars, similar to the 90s G.I. Joes, they start going up in value as that era goes, hey, I want to start collecting
it. And it's really a great toy line, too. They started off, they weren't even Transformers. The generation one of Beast Wars had a click button. You click the button and it went, wah, from robot to animal.
Right.
And then people complained about it, so the later, like the Series 2 on, you actually have to transform, which I thought was cool.
Yep.
And he's got Fox.
Check out the case right here. So all sorts of different eras of Transformers. Were you a big Power Rangers kid?
You know I wasn't. That was about the time that I just started getting in. That was, I think, video games took over then. And I like X-Men. X-Men beat Power Rangers in every way. So.
Yes. So Power Rangers, that was my brother's jam. He was 4 years younger than I was. But again, yeah, video games started taking over my life as well.
15
college. Yeah, I think I just missed it. Cindy, do you want to introduce your special friend over here?
Yeah, this is Corey, my girlfriend. She is a fan of all vintage sci-fi. So she got a ET, and actually Chris gave her a free vintage ET.
Look at that!
What?
That is so awesome.
I'm sure it'll be framed enough on the wall in about a day.
Yeah.
Oh, you got an ET. Can you show the ET glass off?
Here's the Pizza Hut one, yes.
I love it.
Cute.
And then we got the ET button.
Aww.
You got all sorts of cool pins as well.
Yes.
And I remember seeing the
ET
vintage
right
ET. What about ET do you really love? Is it just a sentimental
movie
from your
childhood? It was my favorite movie when I was a kid.
Really?
Yes.
Did you want to own ET yourself?
We were talking about it. He kind of freaked me out, especially the one scene where he pops out of the
closet.
Field. Yeah. No. Whenever he's in the wild.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. And he's like, that kind of freaked me out, but I love him now.
Awesome. Glad. Well, cool. Thanks for sharing your ET session. The California Raisins, the most rare toy line ever to exist.
So what do you think is a good price on a Shogun?
Well, it just depends. Shogun Warriors.
What, the Godzilla?
Oh, the Godzilla. I don't know. Does he have his tongue? Does he have
this tongue and lever?
The lever's always broken. The toes can break. The fist will break or be gone all the time. So Clint's really loving this. Is the some toy places will have a not for sale bin, which frustrates people like Clint and I, because we're like, we want it, but the toy,
we understand as collectors.
We understand, because who we just met, Chris, he doesn't have a toy store because he's not a collector. No, he's a collector. He has a passion for toys, So he wants to put some of his personal favorites on display as well, and there's stories behind things. So this is his not for sale cabinet, which has some really high-end type items or things that he loves the most, such as those Shoguns. And what Clint was describing was the Shogun Godzilla. People love that one. I love it. I have one myself. A Yoda. And then, do you know who this is? Right here. Remember her?
That's from Narnia.
Yes, very good. The White Witch. Right, White Witch from Narnia. I didn't know they made a statue.
That's really cool.
Like that. That is pretty neat. As you can see, I mean, this toy store is massive. You definitely need to check it out. I'm just scratching the surface, kind of going around the outside, hitting some of the toy lines that I really love. But inside, you have all sorts of fun things from all different eras. Even going up here to before my time, Bionic Woman, and sorry with the glare and whatnot, Doctor Who, which I know.
It's not showing some skin.
Oh my goodness. Look at that. That is. Well, let's see. It's infected right now. Uh-oh.
Speaking of big reveals, you show them the Grail?
Let's see it.
The Grail.
Where is the Grail? Everything is a Grail. What are you talking about?
Stretch Armstrong.
Oh, come on.
With the Band-Aids.
Oh, no effing way, dude.
And the stretcher.
You, that is beautiful.
I haven't seen a stretch monster. Do you have a price on that, or is that?
No, it's the stretch monster is $3.
Yeah.
It's not bad at all.
$3 million. Perfect.
You can get him professionally regelled if you'd like.
I've heard about that.
We had the stretch circuit, had that done.
Yeah, yep.
Got tons of Star Wars from all different eras, from the beginning to the modern. I mean, they'll
also,
never.
Also, did you tell them that our Porg is world famous because the Porg's been on TV? Yeah.
What are you talking about?
The Porg has been on TV.
On what TV? Look at that.
Local news.
Oh my gosh, that gigantic Porg in the back?
Yeah, both of them. So that one's mine.
Yep.
And then this one came in sealed. So we have two Porgs.
Where do you buy this ginormous Porg at?
The Porg was the Target. It was Force Friday from 3 years ago.
Yep.
Two per store.
Oh my.
Well, we won one and then a friend bought the
other. Hey, my pet monster.
He's got mange, he doesn't have handcuffs.
Yeah, that's very common that they're all gone.
And probably our most prized possession is the sail barge.
Yes. That was a, what, like a, not
a
Kickstarter, but a
Kickstarter Haslab.
Yes, and look at that. Did you set this up yourself?
I did.
You got sand in there.
Sand.
You got a beautiful diorama working. When I met you at Kane County, I can't remember what the name of that spider is that's in Jabba's palace. It's something similar. Yes. But I got a pre-production one out in the parking lot prior to the show starting. A guy goes, "Hey, I bet you would like this."
And one of my favorite pieces is the Rise of the Resistance, the Coke bottles.
Like a thermal detonator.
They were banned from flight, so the people drove back and gave them to us. So we appreciate our customers so much. We always have stories, and we appreciate everybody that comes in, for sure.
And that's definitely part of it, you know, stories behind. Now, I understand that your store is also connected to a Lego.
Yes.
Is that part of your business as well?
We are separate owners. Doug Davis, he's world-renowned. He's been to several. He travels a lot.
Yes.
We have probably the largest brick or Lego store in our state of Indiana.
I believe it.
So you walk into Lego.
Oh, come on.
Two stores in one.
Look at the Legos.
We're going to give you a special, we're going to go back door here.
Whoa, all access pass.
All access pass.
Yes.
So if you Google Planet Star Geonosis Lego.
Planet Star what?
Geonosis Lego.
Yes.
If you Google that. We don't have it working at the moment.
Right.
But this goes on. This travels to all the Lego events since Brickmasters is right now.
Oh, come on. Geonosis.
It's all battery powered. Takes up 6 to 7 tables.
Oh,
got a
little
bit of everybody in there, some hidden gems.
Yes. And you said it's working, meaning the conveyor belts move.
Everything works, and spins, moves.
This is hard to take in because there is so much. Who made this?
Doug Davis. It's a block party.
It's a block party, Doug Davis.
It took him approximately 6 months, and it's probably worth value-wise, it's probably worth anywhere from $15,000 to $20,000 for all the parts.
Yeah, and obviously for people watching at home, this is not a set you can buy. This is made by an artist. This is technically a work of art that he just didn't slap together. No, he had to look at scenes. He had to have inspiration. And there's another layer to it, the top, which is down here. This has to be pretty darn heavy, I would assume. Look at that. So this is the topper piece to the mountain. And I'm assuming that, oh, look at, there's other spots right there. Oh, I am loving it. I am definitely loving it with all the battle droids. And you got Jango Fett or some of the Mandalorians down there.
C-3PO's head's on the conveyor belt.
Is it
somewhere.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, that's funny. We had a game, find the C-3PO.
Ah.
His head's on there somewhere, but yes, it's a pretty amazing piece.
It is. Thank you definitely for showing me this. And this is like the sorting area of Legos, which is just out of control.
Yes.
I love it. Holy moly. Does he buy Lego sets? Like if people bring them in here? And
people buy, sell, and trade. Yes, we're always buying, always selling, and trading.
And that's the name of the game, man.
So look up It's a Block Party. He travels, like, he'd be at the Brick World in Indianapolis coming up in March. It's a great show. It's super hot now because of Brickmasters on Fox, but it's a fun time, and it should be a great show.
Wonderful. Thanks you for showing me this backstage area. We'll continue our tour.
I was going to say, you want to look at my favorite stuff? I'm going to try to fleece.
Absolutely.
Fleece. Yeah. I got to shake someone down for this.
What?
I was telling her about the Lego that I found on you with the gold chain.
I didn't realize that Lego had so much now. It's
awesome.
A few years. It's insane.
Look at this.
These were my favorite sets.
Yes.
We should do a custom pinball Clint Edwards gold tooth.
Oh.
We have. For Christmas, she got me a Lego guy with a gold tooth, and I built her up like Barbarella, and I put it into a snow globe. I'll send you a picture of it. That was her Christmas gift this year.
Nice.
That was amazing.
These, yeah. No, that really is super, super beautiful.
I want.
This is what Clint wants to strong arm out of him.
See, and these are, I mean, 2 to 250 is about normal.
Yeah, for a complete one, that's.
I mean, 200 I think is low for one in nice condition, because usually they have one of four issues. Hand is gone,
yep.
Broken. Toes are gone or broken.
Right.
Tongue is gone or broken, or liver is gone or broken, and something I've seen more and more with them is the head.
They split. Start splitting because yeah. They're improperly kept outside, hot, cold, yeah. Hot, cold.
This is one I want to bring home. I think. Will retail at $250, maybe
I
more.
Think so.
I think maybe more.
Yeah, for a nice mint one, I think you're right.
I haven't seen many nicer than this. The paint is about perfect. The toes aren't broken. The fists still shoot and work. It has the ring and the fist. It's a two-piece thing. Usually breaks off. The tail isn't broken.
Yeah, like mine, my lever's broken. My fist, it doesn't lock in no more. I mean, it's there, but it just... I don't know, the ring inside kind of wore away, but...
This is his not-for-sale area, and I totally get it, but I also totally want it.
Nah! Well, you never know. Someone... Oh, my gosh. I was looking for these freaking things forever!
Amazing, and he's only $10.
And they weren't for sale on eBay. I had to save a search and wait months and months, and I finally got one. And it's almost impossible to make them stand because the magnets are so weak inside, and these are all magnetic points. It's a really, really neat, like, dollar store type thing from the 90s, but
Yeah, some of these are going to have to come home with me.
There was a toy line that was obscure in the 80s called Mighty Stretchoid Warriors.
Okay.
Like this black stretchy material that you could put armor on.
Yeah.
And they weren't good for anything because if you played with them once, they got dust on them.
Right.
They were tacky warriors. You could throw them against the wall and they stick.
Yes.
One play and they're done.
Mm-hmm.
But these went a step further and you put armor on them. They're super expensive now because they degraded over time.
Right.
He just has such weird, cool toys and a lot of.
Oh my god, he's got more of them down here.
A ton. Yeah.
Look at these.
And there are four. You get a whole set. And you never see these. I actually thought about buying one of these. Just because it's such a weird
toy. I spent $20 a piece on it. Yeah. I guarantee you looked this up on eBay. There's none.
Yeah, probably.
But it's a weird. I mean, there's only 10 of us that want them on the face of the planet.
Those people probably really want them.
Right.
The reboot action figure that I really want to. You
know, oh, of course. I remember watching the cartoon series. I heard they were going to reboot the reboot.
They talked about it. It was way ahead of its time, man. It was like this weird 3D rendering.
CGI type stuff.
Absolutely.
Here it is.
And back on duty.
So, reboot, really odd. I mean, weren't they trapped in this?
They're like trapped in a weird sci-fi multiverse. They couldn't get out. That was the entire premise of the show, was how to escape.
Did you watch the last episode? I wonder if they got out.
My brother Colt, but I'm actually going to pick this up for him because he's a huge fan of reboot.
Oh,
like,
cool.
That was his guilty pleasure in like middle school. Whenever you're not supposed to watch cartoons anymore, you get around it by watching the 3D animated, because that's totally okay.
Absolutely. I love it.
So I think we're going to pick this up for him.
Oh, cool.
Just for all the stuff he does for me, because it's weird and he likes the odd. Yes. You never see these.
No.
I like that he buys not just, you know, like you said, we're curated. We decide what we want to buy.
Yep.
He buys the oddities that you don't see other places, and I really appreciate that.
Absolutely.
A lot of guys won't even mess with
it. I think Diaz needs this.
No, he doesn't.
girlfriend part two. Yes.
Girlfriend number two. Girlfriend reboot.
Yeah.
Nah. Let's look around in kind of the center areas.
My Little Pony.
Oh, I saw something I really wanted to.
I'll buy the reboot toy too.
Ah, I can't find it. Okay, I'll find it in a minute.
There you go, find it.
All right, we got reaction, Back to the Future. These are kind of the reboots. They're made. Super 7 sells a lot of them on their website. But vintage kind of Star Wars-esque looking figures with limited articulation, but of toy lines that they never
made. What
does
articulation mean?
Articulation, like the shoulder is one point of articulation. It moves articulation. So only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points of articulation. Whereas G.I. Joe would have much more.
Thank you.
You are welcome. Things that I didn't realize they made Call of Duty action figures, that's new, and I like seeing stuff like that. So if you were, say, a World War II buff or whatnot, I mean, that is a really cool looking darn figure that you could put on your shelf for display, and you wouldn't even have to necessarily be a video game connoisseur. $25. Shout out to Matthew Rodriguez, Tulip City Comic Con. Matthew Rodriguez is a huge Kevin Costner fanboy, and he loves Robin Hood.
For some reason, that doesn't surprise me.
Prince of Thieves. And it's just bizarre, you know? This is made in 1991, so it's 29 years old, and it's $8. Like, it's probably only $5, $3, $4 when it retailed. And it just is supply and demand. There's not a lot of people out there that love this movie. Continuing Final Fantasy, huge fan of. Here's some more Transformers.
That's pretty unique. The only $65 for Optimus Prime, and you got the foam insert, which is neat. Some of the other nice ones down here, Soundwave, the Micro Masters, Amigo. Surprising. I'm not really up to date on the Amigo prices, but $20. Maybe Superman probably had an S on his chest, and if you had the S still, it'd be worth much more. I mean, condition. No, I'm the has to be a...
They made an entire knife round.
Yeah, like another round of it.
I want to say. Because
the vintage one would be crazy expensive.
Migos aren't as bad as... They had a really big pop a few years ago, but they kind of cooled down a little bit. He does have a bunch of original Migos over there, I believe.
Yeah.
Some of these are the reissues. I think that Superman's original... that's a reissue,
You can tell by the patina.
Yeah,
this is played. This is too perfect to...
He's got some over there, I believe, that are original. But I've had a couple. I had the Mr. Mickle Flick, which is big and bulky and weird, but actually I have a tattoo of them.
I feel like that's not surprising.
Migo was something I never got into because they were something where the accessories would outweigh the value of the figures really quickly. So if you lost something, you'd be very frustrated.
Absolutely.
And I would always lose that.
And you know, I would always lose.
But they're such a cool figure to come back because they kind of transcend that. Boys can't play with dolls. Dolls can't be for boys. But I mean, they're action figures. They're something that anyone can enjoy. And they've got male, female, Stan Lee.
Stan Lee.
Yeah.
Isn't that cool?
Sorry, Stan, your glasses are jacked up. I saw in one of the Facebook groups recently someone selling a pair of Stan Lee worn glasses that were prescription, like the ones he's always wearing, and they wanted an ungodly amount of money, like $15,000, and that could be way off, but it was way up there. Did you ever get into The Walking Dead?
I never did. That was one series. It wasn't that I didn't like it. It was by the time... I thought about watching it there on season 5.
And you went, nah, it's too much, too far.
Like, yeah. She wants to watch Game of Thrones. I told her we have to wait until we're married.
That's what I said. Yep. I know. Game of Thrones is one I never got.
That's my wedding gift. Well, it's like a 400-hour adventure. Like,
right.
We've got to be committed, and I need a ring to do it.
So who needs to propose to who, then?
I told her I don't necessarily believe nor disbelieve. So it's kind of on her.
I remember these conversations. I'll keep them to myself.
Here, check, I want to show this. I love seeing mint in box G.I. Joes, and this is a really neat one. He's wants $300, but it has sealed contents, the Zartan. Zartan was not available as a carded figure, so you only had to buy him through this, vehicle accessory. This is a wonderful store. There's lots more to see, so check it out. I love you all. Hit that subscribe button. Take care.
I'm video recording. Go away.
All right. Now, I know I said we were done, but there's an intense negotiation going on back here. Now, we showed you the not-for-sale box, which... You know, Chris is a collector. He loves this kind of stuff. So I understand those things that he doesn't want to sell because he just wants to have them and it makes him feel warm and fuzzy inside. But Clint also wants one of these things. So let's see.
How is it Godzilla?
Godzilla.
It is Godzilla.
Now, I've got a Godzilla tattoo. And I never wanted to sell a ton of stuff. I had Lord of the Rings Knickerbocker figures, which we know what they are. No one else does, but they're... Never wanted to sell them. Then I had a wreck. Had to sell them. I had my Dungeons & Dragons line. Never wanted to sell them. Had to sell them to open up an arcade pinball place. This is one that I've never owned. But I think there are two rules in toy collecting that stand above all. Everything does have a price. But more importantly, if you buy toys, you'll find it again.
You'll find it again.
That is our motto. It always comes back.
Exactly.
And I'm happy to help Clint out. So,
what's going on with this? I've been hearing Clint... Asshole, Chris, several times.
A while ago, asked if you had one, like probably 8 months ago, and that was after we were already friends.
Yep.
So, these always have one of four major glaring issues. The tongue is either discolored or out, the lever is either discolored or out, the toes are broken. And toes broken is probably my biggest bugaboo, because you can see it from the front.
Yep.
And then the fist. And the fist can be broken, it can be missing, yada yada. This one is, on the little lever, you can see maybe a kid chewed on it a little bit, but it's about as mint as one can get.
And it has the tail.
And it has the tail.
The tail's not always mint, and it's also, a lot of times it discolors too.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's multi-discoloring from sun and stuff like that. So
this one is beautiful. So it's not only going to go home, it's going to go on display at either High Score Saloon or our kids' arcade.
So you guys made a deal?
Yeah,
you guys? Oh, wow.
It's going to come home from...
Look at that.
Yeah.
That's...
I hate to...
I hate to muscle on somebody, but I know he'll get another one. I won't.
As long as you promise you get buried with it. Ever sell it, or if you ever do sell it,
sell it back.
Sell it back.
Well, it's the finest looking reproduction I've ever seen, so.
I'm
right.
That's the thing, too. When you buy from someone reputable and you buy from a toy store that actually knows what they have and knows what they're doing,
yeah.
You know you're going to get something that's quality and you're going to, you know, actually be happy to have it. So I'm pumped to bring home with me. I've always wanted one. And you know what? I've come across crazy toys. And never this one.
Yeah.
And I've come, you know, I had a remote control Voltron that is crazy expensive.
I love that.
See, and the thing worked. I bought that, and a week later, I bought another one.
What?
And I've never found one of these. And these were huge. They were everywhere. My brothers had these, but they got lost in the house fire. So we only had toys from like 85 and 88 and stuff at my grandma's, but my brother Bear was born in 75 and Anthony was born in 80.
Yep.
The house burned down in 1989, so pretty much everything predated that. They found our G1 Transformers in a bucket that was melted together.
Oh my gosh.
So most of our predating figures we didn't have. Like growing up, I had like 2 Thundercats, 4 Heman's. I was like, why didn't we have these? I didn't know that we had a house fire. I was too young to remember it. Mm-hmm. So all this stuff we lost. But there's pictures of Christmas of my brother Bear sitting with all these.
Oh my goodness.
Like, and these are just beautiful condition. I understand.
Absolutely.
So I'm excited to bring it home, and High Score is going to have a new mascot.
You're going
to
start the negotiation on the other ones now? No.
We're going to go hunt for a new Godzilla, so I'm happy to help clean up.
Chris, what's the story on your Narnia Ice Witch?
So the story on the Narnia Ice Witch, we have a wonderful lady. She's in charge of the IU Law Library. Sorry.
Yep.
And she's been a Disney collector for years.
Yeah.
And she goes and we've had Jar Jar Goofy.
Oh, nice.
And Narnia Ice Witch is limited edition. It's got the certificates. Beautiful detail.
I love it.
We put it in the case because there's no way I'm ever shipping that, mainly because those ice swords will snap off. So she's on display.
So it's not for sale?
It is for sale.
Oh.
It could be for sale.
Oh.
I didn't just talk about these Transformatrix. These are such cool figures. And he was
Which ones? Oh, yeah, yeah. Tell me. I was looking forever for these suckers, and they're not on eBay, and I ended up getting one a little while ago. And put them together, and the magnets suck, and it's hard to even keep them to stand. But I love translucent figures.
No, sure.
They're one of those dollar store toys where you're like, big corporations didn't put out stuff this imaginative.
No.
So the story behind these is actually really cool. I have two friends that are Micronaut fanatics.
Yes.
They go Micronauts. And he goes around, and anything Micronaut related, he picked up and got, and he actually does 3D printing of this translucent stuff.
No way!
So yeah.
You have to put me in touch with him.
Will Jones, nice guy, Micronauts, and he gave us this from his collection, so.
Wow.
Yeah, these are near and dear as well, because Will is a fantastic, fantastic guy and a great customer.
Absolutely. I've never seen these things before. I like that head sculpt. That's bizarre. Just some kind of.
The tech deck, the skating stuff.
Oh, really?
Yeah, kind of a weird one-off. The 90s? I think it's early 2000s.
Yep.
Early 2000s stuff, which is crazy now because some of that stuff is worth more than the vintage because it just hit the shelves and it's gone.
So yep, absolutely.
2000s is a sweet spot for sure. 2000s, 20 years old. It's sadly, as I'm getting older in life.
Well, I'm glad that the Shogun's going home to a great home. And thanks a lot, Chris, for showing me your store. So where can they find you? Do you have a Facebook site?
We have a Facebook site, The Toy Drop of Indianapolis. We also have a YouTube channel. I am posting every week about new inventory, upcoming shows, Can County.
Yep.
Columbus, Ohio Toy Show. Look us on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram, and we appreciate it.
I'll put links down in the description for everybody.
You are wonderful. Thank you so much.
No, thank you. See ya.
Now a word from our sponsor.
Hey guys, before you decide to sell portions of your collections, or if you get to the point where you want to sell your entire collection, reach out to me. That's how I finance my own collection, is by flipping toys, buying them, selling them for a profit, and then bankrolling it into my personal collection. I have bought many collections over the years from people that just lose passion, have financial needs, reprioritize, what have you. I will be upfront with you. I will buy them for 50% of eBay sold bidding value. So if you have thousands of items or a few hundreds of items, we can work out a deal. PM me through Facebook Messenger and shoot me pictures. We can talk. If it works out, awesome. If it doesn't, just keep me in the back of your mind because I love toys. I love to sell toys because I don't like dipping into my personal finance money, my real world money, to do this. I like to use my Mama Don't Know fund. And my Mama Don't Know fund is through flipping toys. Love you all. Reach out to me if you ever want to sell a little bit or a lot.